very true. In patients with heart failure, many of the patients are iron deficiency. We were surprised to see that more than 50% of the patients with heart failure had severe iron deficiency anemia. The most of these patients, they complain of fatigue, weakness. The causes of iron deficiency heart failure can be multiple. Mostly because of the gut congestion, the absorption of iron is limited, and these patients are not able to eat nutritional food for a long time, and that's one of the cause of the heart iron deficiency and heart failure. The only way to diagnose iron deficiency anemia in this heart failure patient, all the said patients should get an iron profile done, which consists of ferritin levels, saturation, anti-ABC and iron levels. In heart failure patient, oral iron doesn't work because of the gut congestion. The absorption of iron is very limited. The second reason is, even though you want to supplement iron in these patients, you have to give alternate days. If you give oral iron every day, there will be further activation of haptoglobin levels in the intestine, which further inhibits absorption of iron. So iron, if you want to give any patient with heart failure, you have to give alternate days, and that will take a long time in correction of anemia, and the stores will not be replenished. So the best way to correct iron deficiency anemia in heart failure is give intravenous form of iron carboxy maltose, and that is well tolerated, and they do very well with this drug. The effects of ferric carboxy maltose, there are hardly any adverse effects. We used in more than 100 patients till now. We have not seen any reaction. Acutely, they tolerate it well. Some of the patients, out of 100, 5 patients, they complained of fever and body aches 1 or 2 days and rash. Most of the patients who are having iron deficiency and heart failure, there is a complex formula to calculate how much exactly iron is needed. Initially, earlier, we used to use 500 milligrams iron infusion, but now with the new data available, we are giving 1 gram infusion in the first dose, which is well tolerated. And if necessary, after 1 month, we repeat the iron profile, and if still there is an iron deficiency, we repeat again 1 gram ferric carboxy maltose in this group of patients. IV ferric carboxy maltose is well tolerated, as I said earlier, and once you give this patient, the patient symptomatically feel much better, the fatigue is less, they're more active, and negative feelings of the heart failure have gone in this group of patients, and they do extremely well with this iron ferric carboxy maltose. The long-term benefits of this patient, definitely morbidity benefit is there. Recurrent hospitalization to hospital is reduced, but there is no survival benefit with this group of drugs. Another advantage is patients feel more energetic, the fatigue is less, and he'll feel better with this iron. When your iron deficiency anemia is corrected with injectable iron forms. There are multiple studies and meta-analysis of various heart failure studies have shown that giving iron, correcting iron in these patients with iron deficiency anemia and heart failure have shown to reduce morbidity, even though there is no difference in mortality. Recently, 4 meta-analyses have shown that there is a benefit in recurrent hospital admissions, and morbidity is reduced in this group of patients. Recently, another trial have also shown that there is a benefit with this drug in correcting iron deficiency anemia in patients with heart failure.